looked human, but was reclusive, like an Oni. The Crimson Oni wished to befriend the humans, but they were scared and threw beans at him whenever he came near. So the Blue Oni said to the Crimson Oni,
"Akka, I'll cause trouble in the village. You'll come and stop me. Then the humans will accept you."
As planned, the Crimson Oni chased the Blue Oni away. The Crimson Oni's deeds spread throughout the land, and people finally accepted him. But when the Crimson Oni went to tell the Blue Oni the good news, he was gone and left only a letter behind.
"I went traveling. Don't come find me, or they'll treat you as a naughty little Oni. But don't worry about me. No matter where I go, I'll always be friends."
I suppose the Blue Oni simply disappeared, never to be seen again. Only the Crimson Oni remain now.
Still watching Black Clover?
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's his mother!
Of course it does. Otherwise, what I'm trying to tell you is that the Oni have sacrificed a lot in the past in order to finally integrate themselves into human society. But every generation of Oni inherits these traits. So while Arataki Ito has never been known to commit a wrongful act in the past...
But how can
you
do that?
That's a very old story. Besides, the Tenryou Commission is unable to enter territory controlled by some Oni troops. No doubt that's the reason. Don't mention it. I'm just... I could only assume so.
I love this
song. Judging from his previous bouts, he is a skilled fighter with a lot of brute strength.
What's up with me?
Now that you mention it, I see. In fact, all Oni will avoid beans. But if he could weaken him a bit by triggering his allergies, perhaps he'd have better luck subduing him. It just so happens that I have a bad... Of course, I will charge the adventure.
Sweet! Let's hit the Yashiori Island!
Yeah.
Guppy Hand. It doesn't seem to be looking this way. We'll save a lot of help.
Analytics within Google Play were extremely useful when it came to helping us figure out what we need to do in order to continue growing our platform and making sure that our users found it helpful.
Trying to turn my TV volume back up so I can hear this cutscene with Arataki Ito.
No fucking way. Are they really not up to date? Like caught up? Bing, boom, 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 boom. What is opening? Okay, no, that's it.
Beans, no!
I assume Beans at Arataki Ito.
He's crying.
Why? He's crying!
Are you okay? What should we do? Paimon didn't think he'd
be shit, episode 5 is dog?
Don't be alarmed. It's just my allergies acting up. I've got it under control. It's all right. I got this. I just gotta tough it out. I can take it. I can take it. Who am I kidding? I gotta catch my breath here. Whatever it is you want, it's gonna have to wait. I need a moment. Need a moment? That's better. That sure took a lot out of me, though. Hey, why'd you have to be so mean, huh? Surprise attacking me like that. Oh, I get it. So you're here to bring me in. How in the world did you find me all the way out here? Well, whatever. If you think I'm going back with you, you can forget it. I'd walk away if I were you. I pack a mean punch, you know. I don't want to hurt any regular folks like you.
That's pretty big talk considering all the beans we have.
Yep, that's right. Me.
Oh, that's you. Okay. I was about to say, wait, what?
Not when their families will pay good mora to see him again. And the extra mora means I can, give some to my gang. Hey, what's with all the questions? Like I said, I'm not going back with
you. No way, mister!
What did you say, little one? Go on.
Well, mostly she took a commission to bring you back.
Looks like you aren't gonna let this drop. In that case, we...
Uncle Ito! Don't run now. Careful, or you'll fall.
What's taking you so long? You said we were gonna have a beep.
Yeah, that's right. Still going ahead.
Huh? Who are?
Yeah, that's right. I told them not to come, but what can I say? It's because of a little thing called. Come on, just.
Uncle Ito.
That's because Uncle Ito bumped his noggin on...
Okay, if you say so.
Yep, I'll be right there.
Who were those people?
The old lady was Granny Oni. She's the one who took me in and raised me. And the kid's name is Daisuke. I took him in just a while back. They're both like family. They escaped with me out this way, along with my boys from the Arataki gang. If I didn't bring them with me, the Tenryo Commission would be knocking on...
Right, but if you care about the him so much, then you shouldn't...
Listen, how about we make a deal? You two let me go wrap things up with Daisuke, and once we're done battling beetles, the two of us will settle things with a duel. If you win, I'll come quietly. You can take me back to Inazuma City, and you won't hear a peep out. I'll just tell little Daisuke that my friends and I need to step outside for a moment.
What should we do?
Oh, it's on! I like your style. Come with me. Wait,
you play mobile games, right?
What's up?
You play mobile games, right?
Specific ones, yeah, but what? Wow.
Have you ever heard of one called Q?
Called what?
Q. Like C-U-E.
No.
Hey! I'm
curious.
You guys have seen Oni Kabuto
out
in the wild, right? But let me tell ya, once the Oni Kabuto, the grand game of beetle fighting is a match where your beetle tries to flip the other beetle onto its back. Hey, it's not just some kid's game, okay? There's way more to it than that. I have taken part in more beetle fights than you would believe. At least 800. I may have even crossed the 1,000 mark by this point. Anyway, after a while, you can tell a beetle's fighting, but it's not just about all the physical stuff. Oh no, your Oni Kabuto's gotta be in the right headspace as well. Boy, are you too lucky you ran into me.
We're not the ones that will be playing?
Oh,
this anime's
anyway, not a problem.
My cat named
you two might think
Mo,
I'm just
tooting
my own horns here, but just you wait. And by the way, that kid has one tough beetle.
Well,
we can't underestimate
him. Mo gets rounder and fatter every day. Spending most of his day sitting by the window and looking at the garden outside. When the family gets
to
meet
that
name,
Mo
gets jealous. In a fight with Koreshire, Mo was hurt by the family's work storm and follows the advice of another cat to use in his world.
Darn it, they're all gone.
They're making an Ninjala anime. Oh,
it's a whole pile of Oni Kabuto. Now that. Huh? Oh, what the. Ah, no, not lavender melons. Well, even a pro like myself can make a mistake from time to time. It's okay, just gotta roll with the punches. Let's try somewhere else. This is the one! As long as you're in my company, you're
a lazy
on
the
smaller side, but
size
isn't everything in a beetle.
And
just let the expert explain, okay? What smaller beetles lack in strength, they make up for in agility. Listen, you can never see a beetle's true energy. It might look a bit young and docile, but that's got its advantages. Haven't you ever heard the saying, young beetles that have never fought before always... Hey, didn't I say not to worry? Come on, just have a little faith, would ya? My experience is telling me that this...
Right here! Look what Paimon! If we're gonna battle some beetles, then Paimon wants in! It's not like we have anything else to do. When you hop down, Paimon flew off somewhere else. What do you think, Ito? It's big and strong and look back to what you
really
guys found.
I can't wait for the
flesh
to ass tack on him.
Bigger.
Oh,
Nope! This is the first one Paimon's ever caught!
Well, looks like you got a real knack for this. You'll be a fellow beetle fighting expert in no time.
Oh, so overall, not that good then.
Anyway,
God,
you're right.
Talking
with
that
both
shit.
Your beetle and mine, I can tell this'll finally be the one. Well, you know, that's just life, man. There are so many people in this world. So many unrelated things have to come together at once in just the right way to make victory happen. There's this word that really sums it up nicely, actually. It's a coincidence.
As in pure luck? Huh. Guess it makes no difference whether we have Paimon's beetle or not, then.
Whoa. let's not do anything rash here, you know? I think both of these fine beetles have a shot at winning. Let's just hang on to them and give them both a try. Anyway, time to head back and get this show started. Man, I am psyched for this. Woo! Let's go!
Oh my god, it's Arataki Fago.
Off we go!
You canceled.
Finally! You're back! Can we start our beetle flight?
Yeah, sure thing, buddy. But you better watch out.
Don't worry. I'm not...
I've got this fight in the bag.
Huh? When did you...
Come on, you can take him, little guy! Loss in a row.
Stripey Ghost is invincible. Even Uncle Ito can't beat him.
I won't forget this. I'll beat you next time, I swear. All right, Paimon, you're up. Time to give Crimson Cyclone a shot.
All right, go get him, Crimson Cyclone!
Whoa.
What is
that? That one looks ultra strong, but... it's still no match for you, Stripey.
All right, little guy. Use your...
No.
Yay! We won!
Boy, did that one put up a fight. I know.
See? Paimon's got real talent. Oh, right. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
This is for you, Dad.
Huh?
Go ahead. Take it, Daisuke. When we finally get back to the city, you can show it.
But... will we ever be able to...
Of course we will. Trust me. Anyway, I got some things I gotta discuss with my friends here. Go play with...
Good. The kid doesn't sus...
You're from the Tenryo Commission, aren't you? I bet you're here to capture Uncle Ito.
Huh?
Hey, didn't I tell you? They're my friends.
That's not true. I already know everyone in your little gang, but I've never seen these two. Uncle Ito didn't do it, and not only did he not do anything wrong, he also saved my-
Hey, some things we don't tell to outsiders, remember?
Ito, sometimes you need to just say what you have to say. Don't worry about-
Seems I can't hide it anymore. Come with me, I'll explain everything. I'll be honest with you. This thing the Tenryo Commission is investigating, with someone... I have my own reasons for lying about it, and I really didn't want to get innocent people caught up in this while... I'm the same as you. I just want to avoid conflict at all costs.
So why in the world would you say that...
Maybe you don't know because you're Outlanders, but... it all...
Hold on a second. If you're talking...
Oh, so you already know. Well...
So... is the...
Everything about the fate of the Oni is true. The Blue Oni chose exile, but the other details aren't historically accurate. Fairy tales are nice stories, but there's something they leave out. It's a little thing called the cold, hard truth. The Inazuma of long ago was a dangerous place. If you wanted the Raiden Shogun's protection, you had to have a good relationship with the humans. The Oni are a proud kind, so it wasn't easy for them to ask others for acceptance. Over time, the Oni eventually split into two factions. The Crimson Oni were friendly with the humans, but the Blue Oni? They were more stubborn and insisted on keeping to their own.
Paimon thought you were two different species.
Yep, that's right. There's no real difference between us. We just paint our horns different colors to show which side we belong to. Because humans were still wary of Oni at the time. The Crimson Oni always hoped to find a way to live in peace with the humans, but the Blue Oni kept clashing with them. Humans didn't see a difference between Crimson and Blue Oni. All they knew was that Oni were hard to get along with. If things were to continue that way, the Oni were never gonna get along with humans. And so, the most revered leaders of the Crimson and Blue Oni decided to resolve it once and for all. Over drinks, they swore an oath. The Blue Oni would play the role of evil Oni to help the Crimson Oni integrate into human society. But the Blue Oni's leader gave two conditions. First, the Oni must abandon any prejudice they held against humanity. Every Oni was to accept humans in their heart before the humans accepted them. Oni were not to use their strength to mistreat humans, but were also not to stand for mistreatment against themselves. Second, the Crimson Oni were to integrate with human society, but not by trying to please the humans. The Oni were to embrace their own honest characters, their surging tempers, and their awesome strength to win respect from the humans. In other words, they were to carry on the Oni bloodline while also protecting our Oni pride. After choosing exile, the number of blue Oni began to dwindle, until eventually, they disappeared altogether. Since I first heard the story of the blue and crimson Oni as a kid, I've heard it countless times in my life.
So you're saying the real culprit was a descendant of the blue Oni?
That's right. Most people don't pay attention to the color of an Oni's horns. They probably don't even know that blue Oni exist. But nothing gets by the Arataki gang. At the scene of the crime, they saw an Oni. Still, it'd be strange if the culprit really was a descendant of the blue Oni. Exactly. They would give up their life before a bandit. I've always respect. Our pride does not. My guess is that the blue Oni was tricked or forced. That's right. If I didn't step in, the Tenri.
But what does Daisuke have to do with any of this? He said that you saved him, so he knows you're.
He was the one I managed to save from the Ronin after I sent them running from the scene. He was off playing somewhere when they came by and ransacked his house. By the time he came back, his parent. The whole reason I'm in this is to help this kid find his mom and dad again. I never wanted to tell you any of this. My original plan was to knock you both out. There's more to this than just one blue Oni. There's a dangerous group behind everything that's been going on. I didn't want to get anyone else caught up in. That's everything. The whole story. But if you're willing to believe me, then please, give me a little.
Yep, I'm on cue. Just treat it like we're.
So you. All right. I knew you'd be reasonable. I knew it. I should tell you, though, things could get a little dangerous, so.
Don't!
All right, then our.
Peter, you've been awfully quiet.
I'm watching anime.
I know, but you've still been awfully quiet.
Benny's Adventure Team, assemble!
Arataki Ito is a pedophile.
Yo, you must be Masato. Yeah. Not the one that robbed you, though. So, chill. I contacted you before, remember?
Oh, right. Sorry. I'm still a bit on edge after the incident. It's not the first time that's happened to me. Usually, you just hand over some mora and they'll leave you alone. At least you don't lose your goods that way. But this time was different. They weren't willing to talk things over. Instead... I got down on my knees and begged. Said I had a family to care for, and that my business. Then I saw that there was an Oni among the group. I thought he was. But instead, he stopped the others and told them to let me go. Yeah, that got them all arguing with each other. His cohort said that I was sure to retaliate if they released me. But the young Oni was insistent that they shouldn't lay a finger on me. Things got real heated. Luckily, they let me escape with my life in the end. And I scrambled to get myself here.
So he'll steal, but he won't harm people. Seems he has some. Did he say why they were robbing you?
Surely it was Mora, right? What else could they have wanted with. I mean, I can't say for sure. It's not like I asked. But what I did hear them say was the goods are worth more than the merchant's life. Or something like that.
Ugh. That idiot Oni. Do you have any idea where they went after they robbed you?
I have no clue. but I think they're pretty active in the Tatarasuna area. You aren't gonna go after them, are you? Seriously, I'd advise—
Ah, don't worry. It's just a bunch of no-name scumbags. I got a whole laundry list of scores to settle with them. If these two islands are where they tend to hang around, we're sure to run into them.
I recognize Ito's voice so much. Like, I don't know who it is, though. Bugging me.
They gotta pass through here sometime. Let's just— If I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, things might get a little— Oh, here they come!
Yeah, there they are. And one of them ha— Alright, it's go—
Ooh, I get to play as Ito, Peter.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I'm playing as Ito.
Can't catch me! Ooh, looks like you fellas aren't
Holy
going down
damage.
Without a fight. Fine by me. Fight first, talk later. Let's roll.
Finally. To the fairy. Let's get down to business.
Can't catch me.
Ring cut.
Well, I'm about to use it first.
Attaboy! Who wants some of this?
Holy damage.
To the fairy.
That's 22k? Not bad, not bad.
Hey, don't even think about running. It's me. Arataki Ito, descendant of the Crimson Oni.
I hear Ito.
I know who you are. From the day we are born, every blue Oni knows their purpose. We all know our fate is one of self-sacrifice. But what about the Crimson Oni, hmm? You don't know anything about us. Not our miserable history, or any of our names. Mine's Takuya, by the way. But you don't even care, do you? Because those who get sacrificed should be forgotten, right?
No, you're wrong. I never knew the Blue Oni had survived to this day, and the moment I found out, I was determined that I would find you. Since you remember the pact between our two factions, I assume you also remember the pride we share as Oni. So my question is, how could a proud Oni like yourself go and abuse the weak and plunder the innocent? Why break the oath that our kind swore all those years ago? Huh? What's so funny?
Who are you to talk about pride and oaths with me? The Blue Oni gave up everything, just so the Crimson Oni could live peacefully in human society. But let me ask you, Arataki Ito, what exactly do you contribute to human society? You're a blundering fool who can't hold down a real job, a laughingstock of the town, and worse still, you let them get your vision during the Vision Hunt Decree. Protecting the Oni pride? Ha! You wouldn't know how if you tried. You're a disgrace to the Oni kind.
Yeesh.
Hey, come on. None of that stuff's a big deal. I mean, you're really hanging me out to dry here, man.
Since when do you care what other people think? You just do whatever you want. It's not like anyone can stop you. But do you have any idea of the kind of life my kin and I have lived while you've been hanging around in human society from the rest of the world? We severed all contact with it, and since then, we've had no place to live, no stable source of food, no clothing, no medicine, nothing. Besides the oath we swore to uphold in our so-called Oni pride.
So, that's why you joined a band of thieves?
That's right. Why should I accept that life?
It's my Tesla, no.
A worthless oath supposed to help me provide for my family and friends. I've abandoned our only pride.
I'm gonna fight for my family. It's meaningless.
I want to live. I've given everything that I've stolen from humans to my community. What I've taken will at least keep them from starving and ease their pain. That's what matters most to me.
What the fuck?
Besides, the blue Oni sacrificed themselves so that Oni could be accepted as part of human society. If people see Oni causing trouble again, then that'll defeat the whole purpose of the sacrifice you made!
You make a good point. But Arataki Ito's the one who needs to get that into his thick skull. The blue Oni are the bad guys, so we're expected to do bad things. Our actions won't tarnish the reputation of the Crimson Oni. Unless, of course, this bonehead decides it'd be a great idea to take all the blame for himself, completely destroying the trust between humans and the Crimson Oni in the process. He's the one that wasted the sacrifice we made.
Huh? I only had to do that because of you! I couldn't just stand back and let the Tenryou Commission drag you away!
You should get your priorities straight. The Blue Oni are history, all right? Forget about us. The Crimson Oni are the ones who must live on. Why couldn't you have just stayed out of this?
There they are! Seize them!
Oh no! It's a
forget it! This was... I don't expect you to understand me, but you could at least take a look in the mirror sometime.
Hey! He got away! Uh-oh! We need...
We can't get caught here. Looks like I'm up to bat. Just wait here, and we'll escape together when the time's... Whatever you do, don't attack any of the Tenryou Commission, or they'll be after you too.
Who goes there?
Oh, get I have them. To fight them with only Ito?
Attaboy!
My test, oh no.
Come on, men! He won't get away this time! Just give yourself up, Arataki Ito!
Never! I must fight for my family!
It's my turn,
Rocko. It's your turn! Attaboy!
I did it.
Man, they really came out in force today. I'm kind of flattered the Tenryou Commission sent so many. But I still haven't completely recovered from the bean attack earlier. I'm starting to lose my edge. No, no way.
Shut up, Ito.
All that would do is send them after our blue Oni friends
shut up,
instead.
Cephalino.
But I have to settle things with them first, man to man.
Then what should we do? The Tenryou Commission's about to arrest them!
No choice but to keep kicking some Tenryou butt.
Hey, boss. Thought you'd have all the fun without us?
Granny Oni sent us. We're here to lend a hand.
Maybe we can't take him, but we can sure slow him down. Now's your chance. Go!
Hey, I told you to stay out of this one.
Well, we're in it now. Come on, there's no time.
Go, do what you gotta do, boss.
All right, then. Watch yourselves. Soon as I'm done, I'm coming back for you. Come on, you two. Time to roll.
Don't let them get away. After them.
Hey, you guys want some of this? There's plenty to go around.
Run for it, boss!
As boss of the Arataki gang, getting rescued by my own boys feels pretty humiliating. I promise to never let you down, boss. All right, we've got some footprints to follow. Let's find Takuya. Huh. Is it just me, or are there more and more foot... Ugh, a wrecked cart and some goods. Look alive, we've got company.
Look alive,
Thank beg for mercy.
How's this?
Blood of frost! I condemn you!
Seems they definitely don't want us going any further. Let's see what's waiting for us.
It's my test.
Man, fuck your Tesla.
Huh. Besides the footprints, there are other signs of life here, too. Must be plenty going on around here. Let's investigate. They couldn't have just disappeared into thin air.
Take back the shot of Tesla.
Yeah, unless they're all ninjas or something. Hidden entrance. Yes! All right. This is gonna be where they keep all the people they took.
Hyman thinks Talkie is probably in there as well.
Huh? Fire away? Of course I did. But it takes a world-class blockhead like Takuya to think his idea. So I'm here to save him no matter what.
Huh? What were you two talking?
Recommended party level, 90. Oh, that's gonna be fun. Recommended Peter level, 90. I still think you should load up Genshin so I can help you with some stuff. Was that a spider?
Oh shit, a spider!
Yo, if Genshin has spider monsters, I'm gonna quit.
Yeah, oh yeah, I'm a rat and bull, but I can't do it.
So like I actually am an
arachnophobe.
I can't do it. Like I actually can.
All acquired by less than legitimate means, no doubt. And all the more reason we gotta put an end to this.
Oh, she got hypnotized.
I'm hypnotized, you too.
Wait! You can't run! Let's light it up!
To the fairy! There's more!
Mechanisms for. Can't catch me.
What a lucky day.
Coming through. Let's
roar. The refrigerator has ice cream in it. It's only two.
Shudder.
There's more.
The fairy.
Get wrecked, you ugly, beautiful bastard.
You ugly, beautiful bastard.
It's moving!
That's what you
are. See? What did I tell you? Just trust my instincts.
Let's get down to business! Perfect, no more!
Vengeance will be mine. Rack and ruin.
Finally, to the fairy. Finally, how's this?
More speed.
Is that enforced by law?
Oh, you have broken the law. Peter, you have broken the law.
More speed.
You know, I have not seen this movie in fucking years. Yeah. Yes.
I'm at the end of the Arataki Ito quest.
Andrew, they're putting One Piece on pause until January 8th.
Yeah, they take breaks sometimes.
So if you're not on, I think 1006?
Must be holding on to them for leverage. All right, let's get them out of here.
Teamwork is great.
See no more.
Let's light it up. Beg for mercy. More
to
speed.
The fairy.
Shudder.
There's more.
Beg for mercy. Rain outlines your fate.
Attaboy. My blade!
Finally,
to the fairy.
All right, you're all free to go. Sorry, but have you seen our little boy?
Calm down, dear.
But... Oh, you must...
Yes, that's right. Have you seen him? Where is he? Is he all right?
Don't worry, he's safe and sound. Someone's looking after him now on Yashiori Island. I can show you where on the map. He's been worried about you. I bet he'll be relieved to see you.
You were the one who saved him? Oh, thank you, thank...
No, please, no. No need to thank me. It's my... Before you go calling me a hero, let me ask you this. Wouldn't any other self-respecting guy who...
Really? Just one little compliment and it goes...
These vagrants are insatiable. No one dares stand up to them for fear of what they might do.
Well, would they real?
No, actually, because one of the guys, the one... Oh, in fact, his horns look...
At night, he would secretly bring us food and water. Are you a friend of his?
Relative.
Oh, maybe there's something secretly troubling him.
Let me put it this way. There are a few things he needs to straighten out in his head, and I'm here to...
I'm glad to hear that.
Don't worry. He'll be in my truck. Anyway, you should scram. It's still not safe here.
Yes, thanks again.
Ito is such a swell guy.
Huh. A child that made some poor choices. Anyway, let's get going, while we still have time.
I'm getting a lot of chests in this little dungeon. Oh, another common one? Holy shit. I'll take that, because the common ones get primos. Another chest? Holy shit! Shit, I've got like 20 primos inside this damn place. And that's not counting the 10 at the end of it, plus the 60 once I complete the quest. Holy shit. I would talk to Ether Quest to give me the most primos. That's cool enough. But how do I get up there? I think I know how to do this now. Let me come down here and click this one. Aha! And then I go back this
me.
Way.
Climb
up
catch
the
me.
Ladder. Go wherever the ladder was. This is is why I love having a brain. Brain power. I just love having a brain. Alright, let's finish this Arasaki Ito side quest. Or story quest, I should say. This is the final story quest that's currently in the game, but I'm super bored to that.
The jig's up! Surrender while you can! My blade!
Stop chasing me, Onichan. Oh god. Ito!
Okay,
fight
that
back!
Hurt.
Choose life! Also, I just realized James died again.
Who wants some of this?
See no more! Go!
Everybody, stand! Shiver!
Witness the power!
My flame!
Blood of frost! Crush! I condemn you!
To the fairy! My blade! To the fairy!
Yeah! Beg for mercy!
Finally, I...
You think you've won, don't ya? I'll let you in on a little secret. A long time ago, I picked up this ring. What makes it so special is that if you tear one piece, the other piece starts tearing
Newsflash, don't care about your cute little origami upset.
You better stay where you are. Aren't you curious what the other I'll tell ya. It's now the critical component of a mechanism. And when it gets torn, this place goes up in
What? You're gonna blow this whole place up?
Oh, don't worry about me. I made sure that I've got an escape route. You've had your fun. My paper charm! Where's my paper
Oh, I'm sorry. Are you looking for this?
Yes, that's the... But what-
I snatched it earlier. To stop you from
Why, you...
You're one to talk. What about burying everyone here? If you ask me, that sounds like you've already betrayed our agreement, no?
You done talking now? Huh? You sure? Great. Cause I'm done listening. Yeah.
Oh, she's fucking his ass
Great
up.
Great work, Takuya. You arrived in the nick of time.
Stay away from me.
Huh?
I said stay away or I-
Hey, oh, okay, okay.
Just because I won't let him blow this place to bits doesn't mean unless you want to get buried. You should leave this place now! Take everyone-
You won't go- If you were that cruel, then why bother protecting every person you-
I'm not here to reason with you! This sacrifice is mine to make!
No one needs to sacrifice themselves-
Alright, then you tell me! I've tarnished our Oni pride and abandoned our ancestors' oath. Only I chose this path so I could provide for my fellow Oni. I was ready to die from the very beginning. This is between us blue Oni! But you. If it wasn't for you, everything would have worked out perfectly.
They're here. We won't let them slip away this time.
Uh-oh. There's nowhere else to run.
Hey, Tenryo Commission. I'm the one you're looking for. You're the ones in charge of detaining criminals in human society.
Huh? It's like he's trying to reenact the fairy.
Ignore him. He doesn't know what he's talking about.
Stop fooling-
Listen, Takuya. Sacrificing yourself won't- Your sacrifice can't protect me or your fellow Oni. And giving up your life isn't gonna make theirs any longer. Sacrificing yourself is one way to escape your fate, but the only one you'll be setting free is yourself. Listen to me. You wanna be the tough guy? Huh? Well, this is the coward's way out. Don't let your sacrifice stain our Oni pride. The blue Oni have been scraping the bottom of the barrel all these years. So let's give them a new beginning. We've made mistakes, but we can make up for them. Fate hasn't been kind to the Oni? Well then let's tear it up and start over! But before any of that can happen, you need to get yourself behind me and forget about all that self-sacrifice stuff. Now let's go. But we're not done talking about this. Takuya!
Ah!
I'll take care of this. There are still people in danger. Go, help them.
What?
Hey, I got this.
Come on!
Forget about me! Just go! It's what I deserve!
Ah, shut up, would ya?
Yo, Arthur is still kind of badass, not gonna lie. I low-key like Ito. He's cool. He's a swell guy.
Uh-oh. You about to pull for Ito?
Fuck no. Just because his character's cool doesn't mean I want to use him. I'm not a big fan of Geo units. I only wanted Garu because he's a doggy boy. That and he has this, he has this female type of persona character he pretends to be. And she's thick as hell. So...
Managed to save everyone, but what about Ito and Takuya? Paimon hopes they're all right.
Look, well, I'm not ready to go by sports tomorrow. Oh,
that's gonna hurt tomorrow. What's up with the looks on your faces? I said we'd be okay, didn't I? I'm sure I'd be looking a whole lot sharper right now if it wasn't for that brutal bean attack of yours earlier.
Why? Why would you do this for me? I'm the guilty one here. I don't deserve this.
Because we're Oni, that's why. We share the same blood, brother. Our parents and their parents before them never taught us that it was okay to abandon family in need. I just wish you'd come to find me sooner. If you knew about me all along, then you should have come and asked me for help. I never would have dreamed of turning you away.
The blue Oni disappeared so that they wouldn't bring trouble to the crimson Oni. If I came to you for help.
Not to me. I've always respected the Blue Oni for their sacrifice. Nothing they did was in vain. It's only because of them that we have survived to see today and built a world where Oni and humans can live side by side. Honestly, everything that I have now, I owe to the Blue Oni. And let me tell you, the Inazuma of today wouldn't see you as a villain just because of the color of your horns.
You say all that, but in spite of everything, you're barely getting by.
That's just how I roll, man. You remember the pact, don't you? We're not supposed to suck up to the humans. We're supposed to earn their respect. Every member of the Arataki gangs had a tough time trying to fit in. Take Akira, for example. He snores like you wouldn't believe. Or Genta. He's got a serious temper problem. And Mamoru? Even Granny Oni. She got that name for taking me in as a kid. We're all rejects and outcasts in some way, but we don't care. You want to talk about pride? Well, in our gang, we're proud to welcome anyone who's been through adversity with open arms.
But...
Ah, don't worry. The Arataki gang's already a bunch of misfits. You really think you could cramp our style?
We've dealt with the Kairagi and the people they took captive. I assume that Takuya, based on the findings of our investigation, I hereby announce that you are all stolen articles will be reclaimed. That means we'll...
No! Please don't! Without...
It's all right, Takuya. Those goods never belonged to us anyway. Don't worry. I'll help take care of your kin. Now that I know the situation, I'll...
Might want to put your grand plans on hold there. You're under arrest too.
Oh! But no worries. I'll put my gang on the case. My boys will...
Yeah, we've already arrested...
Oh, right!
That's what they get!
Yeah, I guess it's up to you then, Traveler. Could you be a pal and tell Granny Oni about the Blue Oni situation? Thanks. And thanks for sticking with me to the end. Once I'm-
As for you two, lending them your aid when you knew full well they were in the wrong means that the culpability- But, given your unique circumstances, and in light-
Hey, wait! Unique circumstances? Oh, yeah, okay. Cool. Yeah, alright, see you next time. Whenever that'll be.
Okay, this is actually a really wholesome story quest. I like that. I mean, Arataki Ito's in jail now, but, you know, it's whatever.
Well, he's
for
ready.
What?
He's in jail.
Weird. But at least he's not a bad guy.
But in the circus, man ends up getting arrested. See, this is why I don't want to use Ito. I would have to bust him out of the jail, and that would make me a criminal. This man is in jail. He attacked the Tenryo Commission, which are basically like police officers. He went to jail. His gang went to jail. The person he turned the case, I guess, into like a good person went to jail. Now we gotta tell the grandmother.
Adventure time.
All right, all the work's yours now. Good luck. I found this in this cage.
Ah, yes.
So, did they take him?
Yes, they did. But don't be too upset, Daisuke. He and his gang may have acted recklessly.
Yeah, I knew it! Uncle-
Now, don't get any ideas, Daisuke. Ito is a far- If you ask me, I'd say he's like one of those little Oni cop- Though he looks fierce on the outside, he has a kind heart. He's not a-
I don't really get it, but it sounds like-
Thank you, Granny, for taking care of our little boy. I hope that Ito and his friends will be released as quickly as possible.
Yes, you needn't worry. The officials-
It's time we started heading back. We'll be sure to visit again soon.
Ah, I'm glad that everything was resolved in the end. Things were looking quite. As for the blue Oni, just leave them to me.
Do you need our help?
No, no. Besides, once Ito is released, he'll- Oh, yes. And you know what? I think he does whatever he puts his mind to. Back when I took him in, everyone thought I was most unusual. But I've never been ashamed of this name. On the contrary, because Ito is my pride and joy.
Is this the end of the quest now?
A long, long time ago, in a village lost to time, there lived a crimson Oni and a blue Oni. They were the best of friends. The crimson Oni wanted to be friends with the humans, so the blue Oni played the role of the naughty kid. And then he left. After a long time, the crimson Oni was living happily with the humans, but in his heart, he wanted to bring the blue Oni back home. The crimson Oni didn't know where to find the blue Oni. His search took him up the highest mountains and across the widest rivers. He found many traces of the blue Oni, but the more he found, the clearer it became. The blue Oni was hiding on purpose. So just as the blue Oni had once done, the crimson Oni left him a letter.
Dear Owl, I've made lots of human friends now, and I want to have a big party for everyone. I want all my friends to be there. That means you too, Owl. If you don't want to meet me, you can just watch from a distance.
The blue Oni snuck back to the village and hid in the shadows. He saw the great feast and roaring fire, and longed to join in. But though his stomach rumbled, the blue Oni remembered the oath of old, and kept his distance. Suddenly, he jumped! The crimson Oni was right behind him!
Hey, you're finally back! Come on, I'll introduce you. It's time everyone met my best friend.
Okay, okay, I see why this one YouTuber cried now. This is actually a pretty wholesome event. I'm gonna upload this. That was good.